Hi, welcome to an Inventor Pro 2015 tutorial. I will do the simple wrench which I did before in CATIA and SOLIDWORKS. Let's start with a sketch, maybe on the XZ plane. Yes, I want to have a circle, diameter 35. I want to trim it, because I need only one half. So this should be for construction purpose only. And then go to trim. Okay. And that's this point should be aligned to that one. And let's take a look. Yes, this point should be aligned to that one. That's full constraint. I need a second sketch on this plane. This will be just the line, maybe 10 in length, and should be 15 degree. Yes, then I need this point and I want to make it coincident to this one. Finish this sketch. And another sketch on the same plane, another line, maybe 10, and the angle should be 165. Yes, again, project this point and make them coincident. Finish the sketch. Now I can do a sweep with this profile along that path, and it should twist by 30 degrees. Yes. Then I need this sketch again, so I will share it if possible. That's this one, yes. And make another sweep with this line along this path again, and there's no twist. Okay, now I want to stitch those two surfaces together, and then I want to mirror it. Mirror the surface with that plane, yes. And again, I could stitch those two together. This one and that one, and plan done. I could hide the sketch. Okay. I need another sketch on this plane, slice the graphics, and this might look something like this. And this should be deleted. look. This is horizontal, so this point and that could be aligned. Distance should be 7. This distance should be 33.5. The angle should be 75. This angle should be 5. This distance again 33.5. And this could be 20, and from this point to that point it should be 3 to 5 minus 17.5 minus 20. So I need a point right on this line, and this should be aligned to that point, and the distance should be 17.5. Yes, then I need some fillets. With one right here, one with 12.5 here, and one with, let's say, 18 here, and one with 5 over here, for example. Okay, then I need only part of the sketch, so I will set these to construction and these on for construction. I can finish the sketch. And I forgot my two planes. I need two planes. So go for plane, and this should be 7 in this direction and 7 in this direction. Then I can trim my surface. So I go for trim, that's the tool. This should be removed. And again, trim, that's the tool, and the lower part should be removed, this one, and OK. I could hide the dimensions. OK. Then I need another plane with this line and that point. And then I want to make a sketch on this plane. So, sketch, and this should be an elongated hole. Make it like this. Distance should be 8, and this should be 4.5. Let's take a look. That's it, that's okay. Okay, and then I need an alignment of this point with graphics that point. coincident. From this point to that line, or let's say so I have to project this one into my sketch and then I can align it like this and finish the sketch. Now I can make an extrude with the sketch. That's a profile. I need a surface, and this should go up to that point and confirm it. Yes. Now I need another sketch. I need this sketch again, and this was sketch 1, 2, 3, 4, sketch 4. I need a copy of this one. Copy and just paste it on this plane. And I want to change this one. I want to have these as standard elements and the other ones construction. Yeah. And maybe this for construction and this small one as well for construction. Finish the sketch. Yeah. Another sketch on this plane. This might look like this. Then I need a fillet, which is 18 millimeters right here, and slice the graphics. I want to project this and that point. Come on, this one. Then I need a constraint and this is for construction purpose only. And it should go collinear with that line. And there should be an angle, and this angle should be that's 110. Yep, and then I want to project this into my sketch, make it just for construction, and set this point on that line, and I'm done with this sketch. So now I might go for my loft. So next I want to do the loft. So I go for loft and I want to select these edges. So go right here and right mouse button and select edge chain. So you got this edge chain and simultaneously the surface is sort of selected as condition for the border. And again, go here, and the edge chain is still selected, so I will get this one. And now I want to add rails, so that's one rail, and the second rail is this sketch. Six. Now go to conditions and make it tangent, and make it tangent and confirm it. And now I got a real nice loft. Yeah, take care if you use the edges or the edge chain for the loft, you can give the faces here and here as boundary conditions, and you can get a tangent continuity from this surface to that surface and from that surface to this surface. Now I could join these, or first do my sketches. So I will go for another sketch, and that's again on this plane. Slice the graphic, and this should look something like this. There should be a fillet 5. Make sure that's deselected. And the other one is 18. Okay. And there should be a distance. This should be 7. I might need this only for construction, and I need here some sort of extension with a line as well, like this. This should be 70. And I want to project this into my sketch, make it for construction only, and then make these two collinear. And then I could move this slightly over here. And might even, no, make this point, no, it's this point and that point. Yeah, for example, finish it. And then make an extrude with this sketch. And make it symmetric, let's say 50, and confirm it. Okay. Now I could stitch this one to that one to that one, and then I could make a trim. Maybe I change my visual style to one with edges. Okay. let's trim. The cutting tool is this one, and this should be removed, and okay. And another trim. Now that's the tool, and this should be removed. Okay. Now I could stitch these together. Okay. Then I need another sketch. Again on the spline. Slice the graphics, and this could be something like this. I need a line here. Goes up. Maybe like this. And then I could change this to a center line. Give it some dimensions. This should be 30. This should be 30. This might be 10. And the distance, right click, should be 18.75 divided by 2. And this distance should be 25.3 divided by 2, and this point and that point should be aligned. This distance should be 14. Okay. This could be for construction only, these as well, and from here to this point it should be 7, and the complete distance might be 70, doesn't matter. Finish the sketch, make a revolve. Should be surface, the axis should be this one, profile should be that one, that's the profile, and the axis is automatically selected, and confirm it. Okay, now I can do another trim. I want to trim with this tool, that surface that should be removed. And another trim. Now that's the tool, and this should be removed. Okay. Then I need a patch with this edge and that edge. Confirm it. And another patch right here. Okay. Now I can do, or maybe I should change the sketch a little bit. I think this one was this sketch, sketch 8, and move it slightly if possible. In that direction, it's not possible, so I would have to remove this one. And then I can move it a little bit in that direction, finish the sketch. Now I can make some fillets if they're already stitched Maybe I stitch them first. So this one, that one, that one at the bottom, and that one at the end. Apply and done. So now I got a solid because it was a closed surface. I could hide these and let's make a fillet. With 1 millimeter and here with 1 millimeter. It's a little bit slow. Okay. And maybe another fillet here, again with 1 millimeter. Then I want to make a circular pattern as in the other programs. So I will make another plane between this one and that face. And I got the mid plane. Then I want to make a sketch on this one, and I want to project cut edges, slice the graphics, and then I could set a point here and another point there, finish the sketch, just hide the body for a moment, and then I could make an axis with these 2 points, show the body again, and now I can do a circular pattern with the complete body. The rotation axis is this one. Yeah, and I need 2 instances. It's a little bit slow, but I'm done. So again, in Inventor, very easy to do. Hope you enjoyed it. See you to the next in the series. Bye bye.